Glad to see you guys, and just hanging out here at Anaheim Honda Center. Just got off stage. I'm here. I'm back.
El amor, el amor.
Started off with a dream. I was about 5 years old. I was performing in front of my family in the living room, and just had this aspiration to be a singer for some reason when I was a kid. And I joined a boy band by the name of Cumbia Kings. And pretty much started in 1999 all the way to 2003. And just started kind of getting the feel of the people, the energy on stage, having people screaming your name. And it was just awesome to experience that. And I felt like, you know, 4 or 5 years of being in the industry, of being in the band, I just wanted to kind of, you know, take a different step and approach, and decided to do the solo thing. It's a pleasure to be with y'all tonight. My first album was called What's a Man to Do. It sold about 400,000 albums. And the first single out of that album was a song called Don't Wanna Try, which was what kicked off my solo career. Of course, the second album came in 2005 with a song called Obsession. It was a song that originally was from another group, and it was in bachata. And I just wanted to take a different approach to it and do it my way. It was a bilingual song, and didn't know how well it was going to be received by the fans. But it ended up being, you know, one of my biggest records. You know, after that, it was just, you know, it was fun to be able to travel and have people recognize you and notice you individually without having to be part of the boy band that I used to belong to. You know, people knew me as Frankie J, and it was awesome to experience that. It was a blessing, and you know, here I am now. I definitely felt the need to take a little time off because I felt like the business was definitely getting to me. There's greatness in this industry, but there's also times where it could be tough, and you also need to kind of take some time off to relax and focus on, you know, your family. And then I just, you know, I had this itch of coming right back. I felt like the fans, everywhere that I would go, fans would always ask me like, hey, when's your next album coming? When are you coming out with a new single? What happened? You know, everyone always asks, what happened, you know? And I just didn't want to be one of those VH1 reality stories where, you know, the artist is talked about in the show and people, you know, don't remember anything about you no more. The only thing that they know is the stuff that you've done in the past. And I feel like I just needed to continue, you know, to keep going. So here we are now. I signed with Universal Latino, my new family, and I'm very, very fortunate to be with them because they get me, they understand who I am. You know, we got a new single that just came out called Tienes Que Creer En Mí, which is a Spanglish song as well. Gotta put them, you know, put in English and Spanish because I think that's very important for, you know, someone like myself who is of Mexican descent and was raised in a household where there was nothing but Spanish. The song that I have out right now is called Tienes Que Creer En Mí. And I want to do it for y'all tonight, but in a Spanglish way. How many Spanish people do we got in the house tonight? adding that to this new project, and I'm really hoping that the fans dig it. So the title of it in English is Take a Chance on Me. And it started off with a simple piano melody, I guess you could say. I was walking around the studios where I was working at with some friends of mine out of Los Angeles. And I would be going frequently, you know, to my friend's house, and I would stay at his house and just, you know, try to think of different things to do, different ideas. And one night, I just said, give me a piano. I need to be in a piano, and I need to just go because I have this idea and I don't want to forget it. So I walked into, you know, the studio that I was, you know, used to working at, had a bunch of, you know, little rooms, and it was a long hallway. And I went in the very first room that I saw the door open, and I just walked in and started playing the piano. So, you know, it sparked up something different, and I really loved it, that I just felt like it should be the first single for my new project with Universal Latino. So here we are with the single, and we're very excited. And, you know, it's something that I produced and that I fell in love with. So, yeah, it's awesome.